We're going to go over the last major tense that you guys have to learn this year. It's called the present perfect tense. It is a very important tense, especially if you are planning on moving on to Spanish 4, and I will explain that in a little bit. But the equivalent in English would be like to have done something. Like somebody might say, have you ever gone skydiving? Have you ever visited Mexico? Have you done your homework? It sort of lets us know that there is an extended time period in the past in which we are asking if something was completed, or if you're just asking, like, has this ever happened before? The key is that with the present perfect, you're going to have in English what we would call has or have. That's important. Like, have you done this? And then the second part. But it's very important that it has the has or have. So some examples, I have read the news. Instead of saying I read the news, you're saying I have read the news. It's a little bit less specific as to when. They have developed the city. Instead of they developed the city, this might make you think it's ongoing. They have developed it. She has lost her cell phone. You could just say she lost her cell phone, or you could say she has lost it. And we have used technology. Again, this is a little bit less specific as to when. Instead of we use technology, like, oh, did you use technology last night? Yeah. No, this is just, have you used it before? Yeah, we've used it. So I have read the news. Yo he leído. They have developed. Ellos han desarrollado. She has lost her cell phone. Ella ha perdido. And lastly, we have used technology. Nosotros hemos usado. Okay. So this is formed by the following. It's a very simple structure. You take the word haber and you conjugate it. This is the present tense of haber. And then you add the participle. That's it. So here is why this is so important. And you really must understand this, especially if you're going on to Spanish next year. We have a whole bunch of tenses that follow the same structure where you take haber and you conjugate it. In this case, it's present tense. And then you add the participle. But that's always the formula. Haber, participle. Now, if we did past perfect, and just to be clear, this is called present perfect. It is called perfect because it's the structure with haber and a participle. It is called present because this is in the present tense. If we wanted past perfect, this would be in the past tense, and then you'd add a participle. If we wanted to do the conditional perfect, this would be in the conditional and then a participle. Future perfect would be the future tense and then the participle. So it's very important that you understand the structure because it's essentially going to repeat itself and you'll learn an entire new tense just by learning six new words. And then you'll do it again and again and again and again. There's like six or seven of these. So it's very important that you understand this. And normally, there's only one form of haber. We've seen this many times. Señora, ¿hay tarea? Señor, ¿hubo una tarea? ¿Había muchas personas en la fiesta? ¿Habrá un examen mañana? But this is a weird word. When we usually use the one form, these forms right here, that means usually like was or were, it's telling you something existed. When we use the six forms and they are followed by a participle, it means have. So here, what we've seen traditionally has been like, was there, is there homework, was there an accident? But when we use it with the six forms of participle, it means has. So, haber in the present tense is just he, has, ha, hemos, habéis, and han. Just those six. But now we need to tackle the participle, the second piece. And so it's very clear, this part is conjugating, and technically the participle is not a conjugation. It's just an ending that we're going to add, and it's always going to be the same depending on AR, ER, IR, but there is no like past tense. You can't make it like AOS. It's just one ending. The conjugation happens here. But to form the participles for AR verbs, take off the AR and add ado. So hablar would be hablado. I have spoken. Yo he hablado. Yo he hablado. She has used, ella ha usado. We have closed something. Nosotros hemos cerrado. So all you're doing is you're taking off the AR and coming R or any of these verbs and you add auto. And it will be auto every single time. It does not matter if you consider yourself to be a man, a woman, a boy, a girl. It doesn't matter. If you say, I have walked, it is yo he caminado, and that's it. You might see something that looks similar to this that can end in an A, but that is not this. So if we get there and you come across it, let me know and we can discuss it. But for now, you're just going to have it end in auto. If it's an ER or an IR verb, it's going to end in ito. So, and if you have had homework, a lot of homework, yo he tenido mucho tarea. I have slept, yo he dormido bien. I took off the IR and dormir, and I just added ito. They have eaten, ellos han comido. Just added ito at the end. Sido, ido, and perdido. There are some times when it's not just going to be ito, but it might be ito with an accent. And when that happens is when you have a verb that ends in a vowel. So caer, if I took off the ER, it would end in an A. Traer, if I took off an ER, it's going to end in an A. Reir, if I took off the IR, it ends in an E. So in these examples, because you have the last letter when you take off the ending, the ER, the IR, the last letter is a vowel. And because of that, we're going to add an accent on the ido. And that breaks up what's called a diphthong, but we're just going to simply add the accent. So caer changes to caído. If you don't have the accent, this would be pronounced caído. It's not caído, it's caído. The A and the E have to be in separate syllables. Caído instead of caído, which is two syllables. Caído versus caído. So that's why we're adding the accent. Traído, reído, oído, creído, leído. So those are kind of weird sometimes when we get the last letter being a vowel. Now, there is a fairly big list of the irregulars. I guess there's one more step here. To say there has been a lot of something, like there's been a lot of homework, you just put this word, which is haber, in the correct ending, like these, and then you change the second part. You put haber again in the participle, which is always going to be habido. Ha habido mucha tarea. Ha habido muchos exámenes. Ha habido mucho tiempo malo recientemente. It just means there has been, and that's it. So now the irregulars. There are a fair amount of irregulars, but again, I recognize that this is a big list, but you need to recognize that when you learn the irregulars for this tense, you are quite literally learning the irregulars for an additional 5 or 6 more tenses. So really put the time in to learn these participio pasado irregular conjugations, because again, next year, when I ask you to do the conditional perfect, you'll know these already. Or if I ask you to do the past perfect, you'll know it already. And it's very simple. So these are just like a game of study, 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 study. And you've seen some of these before. You've heard frito. You might have heard papas fritas, which again, that's that example I was talking about earlier where it doesn't end in an O. We're using it as an adjective. But you've seen a word like frito. You've probably seen a word like visto, like buena vista or hasta la vista, which is similar. It's close. You might have seen, let's see. Oh, there it is. Here, hecho. Sometimes if you look at the tag on your clothes, you'll see something that might say like hecho en Mexico, made in Mexico. So you got to study these. And for this tense, they're always going to end in an O, never with an S or anything like that, ever. Even if it's multiple people, it just ends in the O. So some observations really quickly. You can never separate haber from the participle. So this must be directly followed by this. You can't say like yo he no bailado. That doesn't work. It has to go before. Like yo no he bailado. And you also can't do like reflexives that way. Like you can't say like yo he me duchado or something weird. It has to be yo me he duchado. He duchado has to be together. You can never ever separate these two things. They always go as a team together, one following the other. And the only thing that really changes or conjugates in the whole sentence is haber. Okay. So this is it. Yes, it gets auto, it gets ido, and that's great, but you should recognize when you look at this, you'll even see this doesn't fit in the typical place where conjugation happens. So if I do hablar, you know, we have all these, and you can even see A is right here, us, and you see hablado, but where is hablado? It's not here, it's not here. It's actually at the top, right here. Hablado is right here, and you can see it doesn't have the six forms, it's just hablado. So that's a little bit different. Yeah, so I think you guys will have probably heard this most commonly. A lot of times people play the game Never Have I Ever. That would be this tense. Never have I ever eaten pizza. Yo nunca he comido la pizza. And then you could say, sí, yo he comido la pizza. Or, no, no he comido la pizza. So if you're feeling confused, please reach out to me. But otherwise, really dig in on this tense because, like I said, it is the same formula as so many other tenses, and it's important that you guys know it. So reach out if you have any troubles. Good luck.